Hello, my angels. A very good morning to you all. Welcome to Gurukul English Medium School. How are you, everyone? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. Welcome back, kids, to the English period. Kids, today we are going to start with part 2 of the lesson. That is the King of the Golden River. Before starting with the part 2 of the lesson, first let's see what you all have learned in the part 1. You all have learned about the Golden River, the Treasure Valley, the three brothers who belonged to the Treasure Valley, whose names were Schwartz, Hans and Gluck. The two elder brothers were Big, Ugly and Wicked. The youngest brother, Gluck, was the opposite of his brothers. Once, Gluck tried to help a stranger, but his elder brothers misbehaved with the stranger. Getting irritated with the elder brothers, the stranger left the house, saying that he will never come back to the Treasure Valley. Later that night, a big storm destroyed everything in the Treasure Valley. The brothers noticed all the destruction in the Treasure Valley in the morning and got a small white card on the kitchen table. Kids, let's see now what three brothers will do for the Treasure Valley. So, let's start with our lesson, that is the King of the Golden River, part 2. Southwest Wind was true to his word. He did not return to Treasure Valley after that night. Neither did any other wind. So there was no rain. Nothing grew in Treasure Valley anymore. The brothers made no more profits. The Wicked brothers then began to make money by selling gold. They melted in a furnace the gold articles they had. Furnace means a container which is heated to a very high temperature so that the substances inside will melt or burn. They mixed a lot of copper in it and sold the mixture as pure gold. Again, they made poor Gluck work in a furnace while they spent the money on themselves. Soon, all the gold in the house was spent. Only one thing was left: a beautiful golden mug that belonged to Gluck. Gluck's uncle had given it to him when he was a baby. Gluck used to drink both milk and water from it. A strange beard face was delicately carved on the mug. Delicately means hear carefully. Gluck was very fond of the mug. He did not want to part with it. But his wicked brothers only laughed at him and threw the mug in the furnace. They asked Gluck to pour the gold when the mug was melted and went out on some wicked enterprise. Enterprise means activity or business. Sadly, Gluck sat down to watch over the mug being melted. But strangely, after some time, he began to hear a voice singing from the furnace. He lifted the lid of the crucible and what did he see? The face of his old beard friend on top of the melted gold. Crucible means a container in which something is heated to a very high temperature. "Come, Gluck, my boy," said the voice from the crucible. "Pour me out. I am too hot." Gluck was too astonished. Astonished means very surprised. But he took hold of the crucible and tilted it to pour the gold. Tilted means moved into a position where one side is higher than the other. Instead of gold, a golden drop came out of the pot. His was the face carved on Gluck's mug. "Pray, sir," said Gluck rather hesitatingly, "were you my mug?" "Pray" means "your please." "I am the king of what you call the golden river," the golden dwarf told him. He added that another stronger king had turned him into a mug by magic. Gluck had freed him from the enchantment. Enchantment means magic. The golden dwarf went on to say that he had seen how kind Gluck was and how wicked and cruel his brothers were. Then he told Gluck a secret. If anyone poured 3 drops of holy water into the river where it started on the mountain top, the river would turn to gold for that person. A person could try this only once. And if anyone put unholy water in the river, he would be turned into a black stone. So saying, the dwarf jumped back into the furnace and disappeared. When Gluck told this to his brothers, they did not believe him at first and beat him. But Gluck stuck to his story. Stuck to his story means did not change his story and kept repeating it. So, at last, they believed him and began to fight over who should have the first chance to go to the Golden River. They fought so much that the police came to see what had happened. Hans ran away when the police came. But Schwartz was caught and put in prison. Hans was happy that Schwartz was in prison. The very next morning, he went to the church, stole some holy water, and set off for the mountain. It was not easy to climb the mountain. He was tired and thirsty. Soon, Hans thought that he would drink some of the holy water himself. Just as Hans raised the flask of water to his lips, he saw a little puppy on a rock. It looked as if it was dying of thirst. Hans only pushed the animal away with his foot, drank some water himself, and passed on. The climb now became more difficult. Hans felt thirsty again. He was going to drink some more of the water when he saw a little child on a rock ahead of him. The child was lying lifeless, its lips parched and burning. Parched means very dry. Ignoring the child, Hans drank some more water himself and passed on. The climb had now become very, very difficult. Somehow, Hans reached the top of the mountain from where the Golden River sprang. A faint cry fell on his ears. He then saw a weak old man stretched on a rock. "Water," the man said. "Water, I am dying." "I have no water for you," replied Hans. He jumped over the old man's body and ran to the river. The sun was about to set. The river shone golden in the light of the setting sun. Hans threw the flask of holy water into the river. But alas, the river did not turn to gold. Instead, there was only a black stone where Hans stood. When Schwartz returned from prison, he took some of Gluck's money and bought some holy water from a bad priest and set out for the Golden River. While climbing the mountain, Schwartz too saw the fair child dying of thirst and passed on without giving him water. As he had climbed a little higher, he saw his own brother Hans stretched on a rock asking for water. But the wicked Schwartz only laughed aloud and went on without giving him any water. Alas, when he cast the flask into the stream, he too was turned to stone. Gluck waited and waited for his brothers, but they did not return. At last, he decided to visit the Golden River himself. He went to a good priest who willingly gave him some holy water. Gluck was young and small, and he too found the climb very difficult. After he had climbed for an hour or so, he became very thirsty. He was about to drink some water when, like his brothers, he saw an old man. The old man walked towards Gluck, leaning on a staff, and asked for some water. Staff means a long, thick stick. Gluck saw that the old man was pale, tired, and thirsty. So he gave him the bottle of water. The old man drank up nearly 2/3 of the water. Then he returned the bottle and wished Gluck well. Gluck did not have any water himself, but as he went on, his path became easier. After climbing for a long time, when he became thirsty, he saw the small child. Gluck was sorry for him and gave him some water. The child began to smile, got up, and ran down the hill. Now, only a few drops of water were left in the bottle. When Gluck came close to the mountain top, he was very thirsty himself. Just then, he saw the poor little pup that was dying of thirst. "I must help it now," thought Gluck. "Otherwise, it may be too late." So he poured the remaining drops into the little dog's mouth. The dog sprang up, and in his place stood the king of the Golden River. He was very pleased with Gluck. The king put in Gluck's bottle some dew drops from the petals of a lily. Then he told Gluck to cast it into the leaping river. Gluck did so, but the river did not turn to gold. However, it changed its course and began to flow through the treasure valley, making it rich and fertile once again. Gluck lived in the valley, helping the poor and the needy. His barns were always full of corn, and he never lacked for money. Lack for means was short of, did not have. Kids, I hope you all have understood the lesson. Now it's time for me to take a leave. We will be meeting in the next period. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Bye. Take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Hello kids, a very good morning to my brave kiddos of Gurukul English Medium School. How are you everyone? I hope you all are fit and fine and doing your studies well. Kids, tell me one thing, at home with whom you are interacting more? Maybe your mother, father, sister, brother, and so on. In the same way, at school, with whom you are interacting the most? Teachers, friends. Very good. Now you people are in 4th standard. Next year, you will go to 5th standard, from primary to secondary section. I know kids, you all are remembering the 4 years that you have spent in primary section and you are going to miss your teacher. Imagine kids, if you are at school, what you will do for your teacher? Teacher, we will make greeting card. We will be thankful to teacher for making us good students. Excellent kids. So this is all about a type of farewell. Same thing we are going to learn in today's class, that is in lesson number 36, a farewell to the teacher. Farewell means a formal way of saying goodbye to the teacher. In this lesson, we come to know how students of class 4th B bid a farewell, means to say a goodbye to their favorite teacher by arranging a small program. And this lesson was described in dialogue writing, in which different characters are speaking about the teacher. We will study ahead with each character by reading and understanding from textbook. Now, dialogue is a conversation between teacher and student. So, here is our first character, Yogita. Our respected teacher, Mrs. Shastri, and all my friends belonging to class 4th B. As you know well, we have arranged this short function today to say goodbye to our favorite teacher. First of all, I request Madhu to say a few words about her. Kids, in this paragraph, we come to know that Yogita is student of class 4th B, is telling her friends that they have arranged a short function to say goodbye to their favorite teacher, Mrs. Shastri, who has been kind and helpful to all her students. Now Yogita requested Madhu, her friend, to express gratitude, means thankfulness towards their teacher, and say a few words about her. Now let's read next paragraph. Madhu, our favorite teacher. Mrs. Shastri and friends, I am really going to limit my speech to a few words. 4 years ago, I never dreamt that I would be able to make a speech in English. It is only because of Mrs. Shastri that I am able to do so today. She is a great teacher and we have enjoyed every minute of her classes. Next year, she will not be with us because we all are going to a new class, but we will always remember her. And I hope, I am sure, she will be kind enough to remember us too. She has said that we can go and see her at home whenever we feel like, but we will miss her next year. Here, in this paragraph, Madhu thanked Mrs. Shastri, her favorite teacher, because it was due to her teacher's effort that she was able to speak in English and give a speech in it. She also appreciates the hard work her teacher did, so they could enjoy every minute of her classes. She hopes that she will remember them and they too will always remember her. But they are upset as they will miss her next year. Since they will be promoted to the next class, but the teacher has told them whenever they feel like to see and meet her can visit her home. Let's move ahead, kids. Yogita, as a token of our love and respect, Shubha will offer her a bouquet of flowers and a gift. Madam, we have prepared the bouquet and the gift ourselves. It may not look too good, but we know you will understand our feelings. May I request you now, Madam, to say a few words? In this paragraph, Shubha offers Mrs. Shastri with a bouquet of flower and a gift that they had prepared themselves. Yogita also mentions, "Teacher, bouquet and gift may not look too good, but the emotional feelings attached along with it are important. To understand and at end, she requests Mrs. Shastri to say a few words. Kids, it is very interesting to read and understand the paragraphs. Yes, teacher. Very good. Now, Mrs. Shastri says few words. Girls and boys, I'm really overwhelmed. I'm sorry to part with you. Of course, but I'm really proud of you. You have given me the best reward a teacher can ask for. The confidence with which you conducted this program was really amazing. You have done equally well in all the other activities throughout the year. I am sure you all have a bright future ahead. I wish you all the very best in life. Students, in this paragraph, Mrs. Shastri tells that she is overwhelmed, means to have a strong emotional effect, and she is really proud of them, and the best reward they have given her is confidence, means the belief that you are able to do the things well on your own, as they conducted this program and it was really amazing. She appreciates and praises them for doing all the activities throughout the year and then wishes them all the best in life. Class, thank you, madam. At last, class thanks Mrs. Shastri. I hope you have understood about a farewell to the teacher and enjoyed the lesson. And kids, you might have missed your class, friends, teachers by listening this lesson. Thank you. Take care. Bye. Have a nice day, kids. Stay safe at home. Do your studies very nicely, as this is the last term of your fourth standard.
Hello, my dear ones. A very good morning to you all. Welcome to Gurukul English Medium School. How are you, everyone? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. Welcome back, kids, to the English period. Today, you all are going to learn a very beautiful lesson, that is Ryokan and the Starfish. This will be the last lesson of your English syllabus for the academic year 2020-21. Kids, as in the previous two lessons, that is Androcles and the Lion and the King of the Golden River, part 1 and 2, you all have learned about the kindness. Kids, kindness is not the thing that should be shown only towards the human beings. Kindness should be shown for all living beings around us. How Androcles had shown kindness towards Lion and the younger brother Gluck from the lesson The King of the Golden River, part 1 and 2, showed kindness towards a small boy, an old man, and towards a little pup. Kids, our today's lesson, that is Ryokan and the Starfish, is also based on kindness. In the lesson, we are going to see that how Ryokan helped Starfish. So kids, let's start with our lesson, that is Ryokan and the Starfish. Ryokan was a monk who lived in Japan. This story is from Japan. Ryokan, who is a monk, lived there. Monk means a member of a religious group of men who live apart from other people and do not marry or have personal possessions. He was a well-known teacher and a poet and a calligrapher. Calligrapher means a person who practices the art of fine handwriting. One day, Ryokan was walking on the beach and he saw that hundreds of starfish had been washed ashore in a storm. Ashore means on the shore. The storm had blown over and the starfish were dying in the hot sun. Ryokan began to pick up the starfish one by one. He started throwing them back in the sea. With Ryokan, his disciple was also there. Disciple means a follower or pupil of a teacher, leader, or philosopher. Watching Ryokan, he said that what is the use? There are hundreds of fish dying. Throwing back a few of them will not make any difference. But still, Ryokan continued his work and picked up another fish and said that it will make a difference to this little fish, and threw the fish back into the sea. The moral of the story is that when help is needed. It is important to give whatever help you can give. Kids, I hope you all have understood the lesson and you all will also help where it is needed and will show kindness to all living beings. Now, it's time for me to take a leave. Your English portion is completed. Be serious about your studies as your exams are going to start soon. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Bye. Take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.